Did you know that a transatlantic flight from Amsterdam to New York and back emits about 2 tons of CO₂ per passenger? To reduce these high emissions, companies around the world are racing to find a sustainable alternative to fossil-based jet fuel. Now imagine a world where planes fly on fuel made from oil-rich, single-celled organisms, microalgae. It's not science fiction, it's cutting-edge science and innovation that the team behind the EU research project SusAlgaeFuel is trying to realise.
SusAlgaeFuel aims to develop a series of innovative approaches to produce a more sustainable and cost-competitive sustainable aviation fuel from microalgae.
You may have heard of biofuels made from vegetable oils or waste oils, but they compete for arable land with food crops or are simply not available in sufficient quantities to meet demand. Microalgae, however, have many benefits. The only things the tiny organisms need to thrive are sunlight, water, carbon dioxide, CO₂ for short, and nutrients. They have a very fast growth cycle, so you can actually harvest the biomass every 1 to 2 weeks. And its oil yield per hectare per year is around 4 times higher than oil palm and about 15 times higher than rapeseed. But producing fuel from microalgae isn't without its challenges.
Even though there's a lot of benefits of using algae for fuel production, it's actually quite expensive to grow algae itself. Algae needs nutrients, algae also needs certain growth conditions to grow, certain temperature, it also needs water source, and then once you get the algae biomass, it takes a lot of energy to actually process the algae.
That's what the SusAlgaeFuel scientists want to tackle. With 9 partner organisations, they are developing innovative techniques to make local production of algal fuel a cost-competitive option. The first step was to find a sustainable source of nutrients and CO₂ for the algae to feed on. What they found was a renewable energy company just 20 kilometres from the university lab, BIA Energy. This produces around 120 gigawatt hours of biogas per year using organic waste and anaerobic digestion.
So we take in food waste, food processing waste, agricultural residues, generally any organic waste, and we convert it into biogas, which can then be used to fuel CHPs to produce electricity.
In this process, food waste is fed into a reactor. In the absence of oxygen, bacteria break down the organic matter and release biogas. But beside the gas, which can be burned to generate heat or electricity, there are also 2 byproducts, carbon dioxide and liquid digestate.
Right now, digestate is a pretty low value spent material. It's used as fertilizer, but we would like to add value to that digestate as well.
The nutrient-rich digestate is valuable for microalgae cultivation, so it is sent to the partners A4F and University College Dublin, which also uses the CO₂ from BIA Energy.
By growing algae on waste products from anaerobic digestion, we're making anaerobic digestion more sustainable and more commercially viable by producing algae. And then on the other side, by using waste products, we are reducing the cost of algae, which hopefully then translate to a reduction of costs in the aviation fuel that we produce. So we are producing a win-win benefit for anaerobic digestion sector and aviation sector at the same time.
And it's sustainable. An intercontinental round trip in a plane powered by microalgae fuel would emit 80% less than a conventional jet fuel flight.
We are making air travel greener by using microalgae.